Hey, hello hackers, welcome to Hacker Associate. Today basically discuss on what is AI powered hacking. We'll discuss like how we can use AI engine for a penetration testing if you want to test API, web application, cloud technology or n number of technology. You can test it with the help of AI engine like ChatGPT or many other frameworks. Another important part we will be learning here is how we can fuzz with the help of AI, and the topic basically called AI powered word list we need to generate for hacking purpose. So you already using roku.txt, right? roku.txt I think is already inbuilt in Kali machine. We already have used all these things in past for a penetration testing, network penetration testing, web penetration testing, and many things we have done already, right? But this time I will teach you how we can generate a word list with the help of AI engine, and you can use that particular word list anywhere, by the way, wherever you want to test. And another important thing is, in this particular section I am going to give you the prompts. Is very important to understand. I am going to drop the particular prompt that you can use it for your penetration testing, specifically if you want to test everything through AI. And I am using everything pro version, so in case if you don't have a pro version, you're not able to do the practical, but at least just check that particular video, you will get an idea how to use AI engine for a penetration testing. So let's get started. So see you in the practical section. Hey, welcome back. Let's get started. Let us start AI powered penetration testing. So you can see clearly, this is basically the sublime, and as I mentioned, I'm going to give you the prompt, that prompt, you can use, for hacking purpose. So this is the prompt, you can see clearly. So this is the first prompt, which we are going to use, create a word list for fuzzing an API by brainstorming potential input values and variation that could be tested for each API endpoint. So this is basically, I'm talking about API penetration testing, and you can see clearly how beautifully I have created the particular prompt, and that exactly the prompt you can use in your testing. So second part which I written called consider different data types the API accepts, such as string, number or dates, and think about edge cases, invalid inputs and common vulnerability. Include both expected and unexpected input values. And another basically a part I have added is called keep in the mind any specific requirement or restriction mentioned in the API documentation. So you can see clearly we are giving indication also toward the API documentation. Another part which I added is called generate a comprehensive word list that cover a wide range of possibilities to effectively test the API input handling and validate its security and robustness. So this is an excellent prompt. Let us start this part full practically. You can simply copy this part and you can simply go to the ChatGPT-4, and you can see clearly I'm going to paste this particular prompt here. And you can clearly see that is going to create everything for me in an automated fashion. So you can see clearly it is started the string area. You can see it's string area, empty string, single character string, a long string, and many things here. Same way we have numbers like 0, positive integer, negative integer. Same way we have a date and times, boolean values, list and array, and file uploads scenarios. So each and everything whatever we require for API penetration testing, we have everything here. That is the first prompt. So just give a try, and as I mentioned, you require ChatGPT-4, basically pro version required. Without pro version, I think ChatGPT will give you the error. So you just need a pro version in order to do that. Second thing is, in my case I'm also using Burp Suite Professional, and I'm using a Burp GPT. So this part basically I'll record a separate video on this area, how to use Burp GPT and all this thing, and how to add that API. So just stay tuned with me. So by the time it is starting, let's show you the another practical part. The second part is basically, you can see clearly, discuss the type of input parameter that are commonly susceptible to SQL injection attack and explain why. This is the second prompt I written. The same prompt you can use for your testing. You can simple paste here, and you can see these are the details perfectly done. And you can see user supplied data is the first field, second is authentication parameter is the second field, third is dynamic SQL queries, fourth is numeric or integer parameter, last is search and filtering parameter, right? And many other automatically generated, and the last one is URL parameter, RESTful API endpoint. So just try this basically prompt, and you can check the output by yourself, this thing, right? Another part is choose an appropriate fuzzing tool or framework for testing SQL injection on the API endpoint and justify your selection. So let's give this particular prompt and let's see like how it can be done. So there are several fuzzing tools available for testing SQL injection. One of the great tools is OSPZAP and fantastic. And we got all the details here. Like, and you can clearly see that, okay, ZAP is, as we know, ZAP is very powerful framework. And you can clearly see here, we have all the information. And I have full course recorded on ZAP freely available on the same channel, Hacker Associate. You just click on that playlist button and you can simple go ahead and you can start learning today. Another tool like Bob SQL Map, you can use it. You can also write your own tool and so on. Another prompt is this one, like provide example of SQL injection payload that could be used in fuzzing process and explain their purpose. So I'll just copy paste and you can specify P here in the front and you can say enter. Here are the some of the example and you can see clearly it is started generating the particular payload. And I have already recorded, okay, the previous section, the extension, what extension you can use, okay, for the particular payloads. And here, okay, if you want to generate a PDF file, that also you can generate, okay, from this particular section directly. Another section is, okay, you can see clearly this is basically the word list which I created, that is called AI powered word list. Okay, I specifically created for API and many other technology penetration testing. So if you just basically go down, okay, you can see clearly like here is a word list with 500 variation for the API endpoint analysis. So what I typed here is, you can see that. Okay, so this is basically the endpoint, and you can see is automatically this engine, AI engine, have generated around 500 plus, you know, username and password word list and the API endpoint analysis word list directly. So you can use this particular technique accordingly. Okay, so you can see that it's already created all the payloads, and now if you want, you can simple like we can simple write a prompt, create a word list 500 username variation for API endpoint analysis. So now it is starting, okay, with this. You can see clearly it is starting everything, and this is basically 500 username variation for API endpoint analysis, right? So likewise, we can do many things, okay, with this particular knowledge, okay, with the help of AI engine. And this is just, you know, is basically nothing I have shown you, okay, like many things we can do with this AI. And I have a full program also available, okay, on my website hackerassociate.com. So if you're interested, okay, in my particular program, AI powered penetration testing, AI powered web penetration testing, or AI powered cloud penetration testing, AI powered malware analysis, then this particular course, okay, you can go ahead and you can explore. Okay, that's all for this particular section. I hope you enjoy my video and stay tuned with us, okay, for the next episode. Thank you. Have a great day.